club, look mommy, I got the ex, I'm into taking drugs, I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love, so come give me a hug, if you're into getting rough, you can find me in the club, bottle full of bub, look mommy, I got the ex, I'm into taking drugs, I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love, so come give me a hug, if you're into getting rough. When I pull up out front, you see the Benz zoned up, when I roll 20 deep, it's 29s in the club, niggas heard I fuck with Dre, now they wanna show me love, when you sound like Eminem and the Hulk, they wanna fuck, look mommy, ain't nothing changed, hold down, G's up, I see exhibit in the cut, they nigga roll that weed up, if you watch how I move, you mistake before I play up here, been hit with a few shells, but I don't walk with a limp, in the hood, in the letter, saying 50, you hot, they like me, I want them to love me like they love pop, but holla in New York, the niggas to tell you I'm loco, yeah. The plan is to put the rap game in the choke, I'm full of focus, man, my money on my mind, got a meal out the deal, and I'm still on the grind, I show you sexy, feeling my style, she feeling my flow, a girl from Woody, they buy, and they ready to go, I'm getting club, I'm full of bub, look mommy, I got the head, sick, getting to take the drugs, I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love, so come give me a hug, if you're into getting rough, you can find me in the club, bottle full of bub, look mommy, I got the head, sick, getting to take the drugs, I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love, so come give me a hug, if you're into getting rough. My flow, my show brought me to go. That brought me all my fancy things. My crib, my cars, my clothes, my shoes. Look, nigga, I done came up and I ain't changed. And you should love it way more than you hate it. Nigga, you mad? I thought that you'd be happy I made it. I'm that cat by the bar, toasting to the good life. You that faggot ass nigga tryna pull me back, right? My dog get the bumpin' in the club, it's on. I'm with my eye at your bitch, if she smash, she gone. If the roof on fire, let the motherfucker burn. The talking about money, homie, I ain't concerned. I'ma tell you what banks for me, cause go ahead, switch the style up. If niggas hate, then let them hate, watch the money pile up. Or we can go upside the head with a bottle of bull. Then the way we fucking be. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bull. But mommy, I got the head, so get into taking drugs. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug, if you're into getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bull. Look, mommy, I got the head, so get into taking drugs. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug, if you're into getting rough. Don't try to act like you don't know where we be, neither, nigga. We in the club all the time, nigga. It's a problem, pop off, nigga. G-Unit.
You know what it is. Bobby in the club. Hey, what it do, what it do?
This is Taco Tuesday.
And we are back in the motherfucking building. And we just came in real quick. Oh, well, first and foremost, let me, I apologize, because we here right now with your man, Step Lover.
Don Gotti Nash. And?
Fair.
Miss Pretty Eyes.
Miss Pretty Eyes.
A.K.A. Riri Gotti.
Riri Gotti. I like that. I like that. So as y'all can see that I'm over here on the side because we got royalty in the building. I figured, you know, she could sit in the middle, you know what I'm saying?
Thank you.
Her birthday was yesterday, so we're doing a happy belated birthday to Ms. Riri.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
And then we're doing a happy
birthday.
Fuck your opinion birthday to Don Gotti Nash. So
yes, sir.
Everybody show some love. Show some love to these two wonderful people, this beautiful couple. And we in the building. We back. You know what I'm saying? Taco Tuesday, goddammit.
That's what's up, man. Thanks everybody on Facebook for the love. Appreciate it. Yes.
Damn Skippy. Thanks for joining us.
We over here on Instagram live.
Instagram.
I don't know when I hit the live button, but
it's live, motherfucker. You might have hit that joint a while ago.
Yeah, we live, but hey, I don't know when I hit that joint. What's up, Instagram? What's going on?
Don got us in here off the motherfucking Henny, the Remy, and the Jim Beam honey.
Yeah, Jim Beam
honey.
Nigga,
this motherfucker.
Yeah, I'm hot as
I'm sweating like I'm over this Jim.
Yeah, I was wondering what was up with that, man.
Well, we are fat. I mean, but just the fat and the Remy and Henny shit. That's it's a good thing. It's a blessing.
So yeah, we was coming in to 50 Cent in the club. That's one of my favorite songs.
Birthday.
That's my birthday anthem.
We came in on my birthday to 50 Cent, right?
We did? I think we
Oh, no, we came in two times.
We came in two times.
It's your birthday. Yeah, them are to me, the two greatest birthday rap songs, to come into, man. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people like the Stevie Wonder.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, you know, that's some good shit.
What's your favorite birthday song?
Yeah.
Sweetheart. I like the new Drake one. The one that I posted with your video.
I like that one too. That was good. Hold on, man, before we start though,
man, let's get this shot in right quick, man. Let's get this shot in.
This is to all the Geminis out there.
I don't drink.
Shout out to all my Geminis out there.
Shout out to all the Geminis. To all the Geminis with the birthday
love. One of the greatest signs of all time.
One of them. Aries is up there.
One of the greatest motherfucking signs of all time. Geminis.
I mean, you guys as family, y'all got a lot of Geminis in the building, right?
Yeah. Shit, we got a lot of motherfuckers. At home, we got, but in the actual family, it's a lot of Aries.
It's a lot of Aries. Yeah. We dominate, goddamn it.
We have four Geminis in our house.
Yeah, we got two.
That's what's up.
Yeah, it's gonna be crazy.
That's what it is.
Two dudes and two girls.
This is to the Geminis and to Riri.
All the Geminis out there. Salute to my wife. Yes. To me. Salute.
Happy birthday to all the Geminis.
Yeah. Shout out to y'all.
To the Geminis.
We the best.
They all the same.
Happy birthday, Kanye West.
Greatest sign of all.
Aries, baby. Aries.
Woo.
Drinking that Remy, man. Got that motherfucker. He got that Remy. I got that Henny VSOP. Riri's drinking juice because ladies don't drink on camera.
Right.
Yeah. That's how we do it.
So yeah, man, we're gonna start talking about the Gemini sign, which is once again one of the greatest signs of all time.
Thank you for clearing it up by saying one of the greatest. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah, the greatest sign.
He said one.
I see, it's like the LeBron
Jordan conversation, you know, Kobe. You know, it's debatable.
You had to throw Kobe in there, man.
Because you know, Leos think they the best. That whole King of the Jungle bullshit.
Yeah, I already told you, Leo's. Me and Leo's is not the.
Yeah, I'm not really, you know. Lorenzo, Trayshawn, Teddy, Third was a Leo.
A Cool Breeze, DC, said happy birthday, Miss Nash.
Yes, on YouTube. Thank you.
PYO Gang, happy birthday, Big Don. Hey, appreciate it, man. Appreciate that.
Yes, indeed. PYO Gang, I like that.
But yeah, the Gemini sign is from May 22nd. Through June 21st, the symbol is the twins. Some of the Gemini traits are it's the third sign of the zodiac, and the sign will be quick to tell you all about it. That's because they love to talk. It's not just idle chatter with these folks either. The driving force behind the Gemini zodiac sign is conversation in their mind. Ruling the third house, the Gemini born are intellectually inclined, forever probing people and places in search of information.
There we go.
All right, I was gonna give you some Gemini facts, man.
Break it down to us.
Let me see. Here's some interesting facts about Geminis, man. You probably agree with some of this shit. Fact one: Gemini thinks too much.
Which I think is true.
It's a constant spin, especially when you got your mind.
But usually, when I overthink, it turns out the way I was overthinking. I'm ready for all angles of it. So overthinking is a good sign of the Gemini.
That's some good shit.
Geminis are extremely independent. So anyone who thinks they can control you is going to have a problem. Yeah, that shit is very independent.
Yeah, I use that to help.
I can agree with that.
Yeah,
I'm definitely independent. Gemini is most likely to speak up to defend you in your time of need.
Yeah, I love speaking up to people. I don't like bullies.
They say we can make friends with anyone. They're just cool like that.
Everybody.
It doesn't take much to make a Gemini happy, but it takes even less to make them mad.
Yeah.
So you say Kanye West was a Gemini?
He is. His birthday was yesterday.
Kanye West, Tupac.
He isn't crazy. He is crazy. He speaks his mind. Okay. And he makes the situation work for him.
So you don't think he's the least bit crazy?
No, he's crazy, man.
He got issues. But you know,
he don't have issues.
3K, 3,000 on Andre 3,000.
Andre 3,000.
Yeah, he's and folks will consider crazy too. Crazy too. Yeah. They're not crazy.
Prince of Gemini.
Prince was special.
Yeah,
Prince. Everybody you said are incredibly gifted people.
Gemini's are misunderstood, though.
We can say that.
The biggest thing is like outsiders don't understand.
Listen, and I will agree with you on that because everybody you've named are incredibly gifted, but people outside would look in and say, these motherfuckers crazy, right?
Yeah, we got issues. I would say I got some issues, but
no, I'm not talking about you two guys. I'm talking about motherfucking Prince and
Yeah. People love him though.
They do.
People love him.
Yeah, especially, you know, Andre 3000 with his musical gifts, with Prince with his musical gifts and some of the things.
And his ass probably, he probably falls into the line of thinking. You know what I'm saying? Thinking.
You can like, I'm talking about Andre.
Andre probably just keep thinking. He probably makes some dope shit and just probably keep spinning and spinning and spinning.
Real quick, you can look at Kanye West, Andre 3000, and even back when Prince was alive.
Yeah.
And when they talk, you can just look at them. They're thinking as they're talking and, you know, as they're thinking. You know? So, yeah, that's
Yeah, so let me see. What else to say? Gemini spots little things about persons that other people miss. Geminis always pay attention to what people do because persons' actions are more important than their words. Mm-hmm. Geminis are a type that are comfortable with being single because they don't need someone to make them happy. They got themselves.
That's what's up.
And probably, let me say like one more thing. Even if a Gemini is going through the worst of times, they keep going because they know there's light at the end of the tunnel.
Exactly.
So it's actually 80 facts. I'm not going through all 80 of the facts.
Yeah, please don't, because Geminis, y'all heads would just be like...
But what we wanted to see is what is everybody's signs out there? I think we might have talked about, we touched on signs and, you know, crazy shit, but what is everybody's signs out there? What y'all think the best signs? What's the crazy signs? I mean, you know.
Leo.
Yeah, I think we said that. We
said, motherfucking Leos are fucking.
What'd you think the crazy sign? What'd you think one of the signs that you had encountered with that you think probably is?
I never really encounter a crazy side, and I'm not that much into the signs. I'm just into my sign and my children's signs, but I never encountered a sign that I would consider
crazy. The funny thing is, when you do read about the signs, that shit do actually.
Someone be.
It be. Like, I read about the Gemini. That actually had. I was like, shit, this me like a motherfucker.
Listen, check this out real quick. Real quick shout out to all of our Facebook supporters. We got our man Champ Chroma. Got our Spartanburg folks in the building. My homegirl Jennifer. What's going on? Scuba Jones. Scuba in the building. Scuba said, cancer all day. Black Lives Matter. Love my fam. We love you too, Scuba. You already know what it is. You damn right, Black Lives Matter. We appreciate your support and everybody else's support. My mother bought me a shirt when she was alive. She was, and my mom was.
And you know, she don't give a fuck if that's your right.
There we go. That's our one. We always got that one instance in the podcast where we got some technical shit. Just that shit was like, boom, wake up, nigga. But my mom bought me a t-shirt once and it said, Aries. It was a red shirt. It had the Aries ram on it. And then it had like everything like you just named about your sign.
Yeah.
And dog, I could go down the list of everything that it said about my sign, and it was me.
Yeah, but that shit make you interested.
Like, it's like, it's yo, me. How the fuck?
Yeah, it kind of, and then you scary. and then you encounter people that's the same sign, and then they be like, yeah, that's something. Then you know a motherfucker that might be a certain sign, and you be like, damn, that's him like shit.
That's them like a motherfucker. Yeah. We got Grandma Nash just jumped in. Hey, Grandma, how you going?
Hey, Mom.
Yes, indeed.
Tell Grandma. Tell Grandpa Nash to say hello.
Tell Pops we said what it do. Oh, Pops, he's still... Pops chilling. I know he's still chilling. I ain't even got to ask that question.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, I love Mr. Nash.
Pops going to be chilling way before all of us, goddamn. Exactly. Even after. You know what I'm saying? But I don't think I have ever had any, like, beefs with signs. I just know growing up, the couple of Leos that I knew... They just that king of the jungle shit. You know, I'm a Leo, or the king of the jungle, blah, blah. Look, assholes, lions don't live in jungles. They live in safaris. So clear that shit up, one. But.
You know what? I dealt with one Leo. Mm-hmm. I met her in high school. We was really close. I consider her one of my best friends. She just had a lion problem.
Really?
She will exaggerate and lie about every and anything.
Yeah.
And I cut her off because she couldn't stop lying. I was in the hospital one time. She said she came.
Oh, man. She thought she was off of medication or something?
Well, you know, my maiden name is Ferguson. She said, yeah, I came. And they said they didn't have a Farrah Ferguson. So I said, well, I'm booked under Farrah Ferguson. That's what my insurance was under. Mm-hmm. So she lied. But her lying was so...
Damn, she lied about visiting in the hospital.
Yeah, I was sick. I was in
pain.
Yeah, she lied. Then
I'd have had to cut her off,
I'll tell you something else she did. She called my phone, and she pretended like she didn't know, like as if it was a butt dial, and she had a full-blown conversation with her sister about me.
Oh.
And it was all nice shit. So I let Dawn listen to it, right? But you could tell it was scripted. But that was like the only Leo that I dealt with that was like.
Was she a Leo? She was a Leo.
Yeah, she is a Leo. It's August the 7th or 9th.
Summer's a Leo. She's August.
No, I thought she was a Sag.
August.
No, she's in August. Okay. She comes after my mom. My mom is August the 3rd.
Trishon's a Leo. Lorenzo's a Leo. Teddy's a Leo.
I don't want to say her name. Third. I was about to say, but I don't want to say her
name.
Yeah,
that's
all.
But
she had a
good
side to her.
I say my people's names. I don't give a fuck.
Like, she definitely had a good side to
her. Yeah, you know, Leo's could be good people.
The lies just started to hurt me. Like, you know what? She lied about every and anything.
But Teddy third, Trayshawn and third, they weren't, Teddy third, Lorenzo, they weren't big liars. I guess everybody can be their own little liar, pants on fire, and their own little, you know what I'm saying?
My mom was a Leo, but she's more of the, she sets the rules. And
it's like Leo. To me, my problem with Leos is they try to be in charge.
They try to be in charge.
That's my problem with it. It's a charge thing.
Well, not only that, when you're a strong sign, like y'all Gemini sign, the Aries sign is a strong sign. A sign, you're not getting over on us. You're not, oh, we're the leader, or, nah, get the fuck out of here. We're not having that shit. Like, come on, man.
Fuck out of here, man.
Right. Yeah. Bullshit.
But being that we are talking about Geminis, famous birthdays that's on to, I mean, we're going to do this later on, but I'm just going to go ahead and get this out of the way. Johnny Depp birthday is today.
Johnny Depp.
Michael J. Fox.
Back to the Future. Man, Back to the Future.
Like some of my favorite childhood movies. Like, I love Back to the Future, too. That's one of my favorites.
Back to the Future 2 is one of my favorite movies.
That's one of my favorite. I just love the time travel shit.
Time travel, going to the future.
Yeah, I love shit like that. I like how they spent that shit where they was
amazing.
The movie, the part one was going on while they trying to do part two. I thought that shit was so dope.
I want to, you know, we might have to do a Back to the Future show because they had to done some hellified money.
Yeah,
that series, man, was Steven Spielberg, correct?
I think it was. Yeah, that was a dope
shout
series.
Out to Michael J. Fox, man.
Michael J. Fox, 59 actually.
Damn, 59 years 59. Old.
Yep, 59. Also, let me see who else on here. Tamala Mann.
Who? What's
that? That's the what's the dude name? That's her husband.
Oh, from the Tyler Perry.
She's the gospel singer.
With the
yeah.
Oh,
damn, what's his name?
Dude.
The little short, the chocolate drop.
What's his name? I can't think of his name.
Little chocolate drop.
Little chocolate drop.
What's
Mr. Brown. Mr. Brown. Mr.
Brown.
Yeah, yeah, but yeah,
Mr. Guy. Brown.
Yeah, Mr. Brown. And then the other dude birthday today too. T.D. Jacobs, I think it's yeah.
T.D. Jakes. I like him.
Great guy. Great man. Yes, indeed.
I like him.
Yes, yeah. my Uncle Rex loves him.
Inspiration.
Very inspirational.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's pretty much the birthdays that I know, people that I know. So it's actually a whole lot more
and
people.
Who birthdays were for June?
Oh, yeah, I'm about to check that now. I'm about to check that. I'm about to get that for you.
Kanye.
I love me some Kanye.
Listen, I like Kanye. I used to love Kanye.
I like him up to the point where he was supporting Trump, but I feel like he was doing that to...
Yeah, I had a problem with his statements that he made about blacks with the slavery, and that shit went over my head. I was like,
but
Slim,
you
dug a hole with that, bro.
But what I noticed about Kanye since the death of his mom, he hasn't been
No.
But I believe
he's hurting. I believe he's counseling.
But it was some report that came up recently. Like last week or so, where they say Kanye said he was doing that Trump shit to get people out of jail. So I don't know.
But then he used that to get the rapper out.
Yeah, he was saying he was doing that shit to get him out of jail. So I don't know. I don't know how true that report is. But
you know, his wife, she has freed so many.
Oh,
people.
I love Kim.
Right, like Kim
that
is really freeing
ass.
A lot.
I
of
love
people.
That sexy beast.
No, I'm talking about as far as her.
I'm freeing. I was just saying how much I love
a
her.
Lot
I'm
of
sorry.
People.
I can't help myself.
What you do to Kim?
Oh, I gotta be nice to her. Because your wife's on the show, I gotta be nice.
No, what you do to her?
What you do to her? You always say it, man. What you do to her?
I eat dead ass, nigga.
So you gonna eat shit?
No, I ain't what? I'm just
saying. Ass.
I'm just kidding.
You wanna know what I do with Kim?
What?
I get her to free some of my family. I get her on some of these cases. I have her working it.
Okay.
And that's what I would do.
And after you do that, I would reward her.
To free some of my family members.
After you, that she went for you, I reward her.
So yeah, on June
8th, all glazed up.
On June 8th, of course, it's Kanye's birthday. Kanye 40, yes, Kanye 43.
Yes, dang.
Joan Rivers, who actually she's passed away. I mean, damn, she's been gone since 2014.
Joan Rivers. Oh yeah, the lady who do, I loved her.
Yeah, like, she's been gone. Yeah, she's been gone.
I didn't know she was a Gemini.
Yeah, she's born on your birthday.
She was really blunt and straightforward.
Yes, she was.
Barbara Bush, she died too. 2018. Barbara Bush was actually
born. I love Barbara Bush. No,
I'm just kidding. That's Barbara don't count.
And you know a rapper named Little Mouse?
No.
Never heard of him, but that's his birthday today, 21.
Happy birthday, Little Mouse.
Little Mouse, who the hell is that?
Yeah, I don't know who that is.
Hey, man.
The little dude that's running around the house?
Yeah. Listen, man. Little Mouse.
Yeah, I don't know if you know some of these people.
Mm-mm. Nope.
Where Andre at?
Well, he not.
I don't think that's legit.
He not. No, this for the actual day. Nah, this shit legit.
That's
as
for
far
June 8th?
Yeah, it's for June 8th.
Okay.
Yeah, it's for June 8th. I just don't know a lot of these people. Like I had some people that was on, but yeah, that's it for that, man. But also
Gemini season.
Also, and on June 9th, 1994, Lisa Left Eye Lopez, she burnt Andre Horizon's
house. Rest in peace to Lopez.
She was also a Gemini, man. I don't know if that was some of her Gemini tactics or whatnot.
Tendencies.
So let's not forget, she did not mean to burn down the house.
From
what she said, she came home and he had, I believe, a lot of shoes.
She got mad.
It was not the size there for her. They was all for him. So she got upset and she put them in the tub.
And with the burning shoes,
she burned them. And the fire got out of her control. And that's how the house burned down. So she did not set out to burn this house.
Just the shoes.
It just happened. Right, just the
and
shoes.
And she burned the shoes because...
And she was very smart to put them in the tub because...
The house caught on
that
fire.
That would have contained the fire, but
yeah, that shit.
Maybe with a walk-in shower. I don't
shit,
know.
She must have threw that shit in like a fourth of gasoline.
To burn their man's house, and let's not forget
that shit had something to make that flame go.
I just got a missed call. That wasn't from our thing, was it?
Nah, okay. I mean, they didn't call over here.
Okay. And let's not forget her boyfriend was in court supporting her through this.
Yeah, Andre Rison was her boyfriend at the time, and it was noted that Andre Rison had, you know, they had physical things going on.
Typical stuff that typical we go through
Hollywood, right. NFL, superstar shit. But I'm sorry, if you burn a motherfucker house down,
and that's a question I wanted to ask. So would you take her or him back if they set your house on fire?
No.
Like, is it a...
Can't speak on that until you go through it. And I believe that you would if you're deeply in love and you believe that this is the one for you. Mm. You go through stuff as a couple, and it's a matter of getting through it, and that's what makes you stronger. Mm. So you're saying no based off the fact that you haven't experienced that deep love.
Oh, I've been deeply in love with somebody before.
So if she was to set your stuff on fire,
if she was to set my Jordans on fire... Alright, cool. Listen, we arguing, shit fucked up.
Set
my Jordans on fire, I can forgive you.
She accidentally burned down your house.
Burned down my motherfucking mansion?
Accidentally. Accidentally. Let's not forget it was an accident.
Jesus, take the wheel.
I think you take her back. I think you'd be mad as hell. And she gonna make it up to you.
Oh, she's gonna have to do a lot of making up, man.
You'll take her back.
I'm out.
Like Aaliyah said, that was a small price to pay.
Shit, I'm out. Fuck that. I'm out.
That's a
I'm
damn out.
Listen,
I'm
man. Out. Check this I'm out. This is the thing, too.
And the house was insured.
Like, well, that's what I was going to get at. Because
so she burned down the house, but let's keep in mind.
Yeah, but she got
it wasn't her intention. It just was the shoes. The house was insured.
Hold on, let me read this, though. It says, on the night of June 8th, Rison was reportedly... out clubbing with some of his friends, annoyed with Andre. Least the fuck was that?
That was a happy birthday.
annoyed with Andre. Lisa Left Eye went out with some friends, but returned home before Rising. Oh, she was fucked up. If she went out after him and then came home, and he still wasn't there.
He said, "Set J's on fire." That the Holy fucked Ghost her up.
Exactly. Come on, man. Like my man said, you gonna set my J's on fire then my fucking house?
Yeah, but he returned home at approximately 5 a.m. on June 9th and was greeted by an agitated Lopez, reportedly angry because he bought himself lots of new sneakers without getting her any in the driveway of his multi-million dollar house. I knew she'd been drinking, so check this out, but I didn't know what was upset her. I started taking blows to the face. Finally, I grabbed her, asked her what was wrong, but she kept coming at me, claiming self-defense. He then, on Rousey, allegedly slapped Lopez to try to calm her down. So he,
calm your ass down, girl.
And then when that didn't work.
Oh, shit, here we go. That's the I'm on the podcast. I'll call you back. Yeah, but listen. I read the story earlier when you sent it to me, right?
So he left the home.
He left the home.
Yeah.
And came back, and the shit was burned down.
And she set it on fire in the bathtub, then went outside, took a vacuum cleaner pipe to the windshields of two of Rising's luxury vehicles. I'm out.
Before long, the entire mansion was
engulfed in flames. Rising's brother, Reggie, reported saying, standing over the whirlpool outside of the house, watching the fire spread. By the time Rising returned of what was once his home, little of the building was left standing. On June 10th, she was arrested, turning herself in. Well, she turned herself in, and she was charged with felony arson.
And then he sat at court with her, and he
was with her
and held her hand.
But he
that's
didn't,
love.
And he denied abusing her, and you that's know it, it hurts me because I'm not like that. We did everything.
Yeah, together. Mike, we talking about left eye, bro. Like, could you still? The question me and Gotti asked was, okay, you in love, sir? You and sir got a beautiful relationship. You got kids. You're married. If you go out and just switch roles, and sir, you come home, sir, done burnt down your Timberland because you a Timberland man. You really ain't no Nike Jordan guy. And then you leave and come back, and sir, done burnt down the motherfucking house. Are you sticking with sir, or are you rolling the fuck out on sir? I'm going to just simply say that after you burn my Jordans, because I'm quite sure it wasn't like two or three pair of Jordans.
Hold on, we did get a call, man. Let me. We called motherfuckers back.
The flames kept rising to the top. That's hilarious.
Let's see who this is, man. It's rough ass. We call your ass back.
Who this is?
Hello.
Hey, what's up?
What's going on, Don?
Not much, man. What's up?
It's Will.
Oh, what's up, Will? It's my man, Will.
What's up,
Will?
Too much. What's going on? Y'all just clowning my Leo status, that's all.
Oh, we're clowning your Leo status?
I want to say happy birthday. Saying happy belated and happy birthday to the couple up there.
Yes, indeed.
Appreciate that, Will.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, Will, my man. From,
no problem.
From when I was a kid, man.
Spartanburg?
Nah, he from D.C., man.
He's playing
DC,
street in the middle of the street.
Yeah, 55th Street. Yeah, man. This is my man right here.
Real quick, Phil. Will, let me ask you a question, Will. Did you hear the question about Left Eye, about her burning Andre Rison's Jordans and then burning down the house? Would you stay with your woman
man,
if that shit happened, brother?
She needed some of her shit burned down, too.
Yes. Some of her shit has to get burned.
But right. Answer the question. Would you stay with her?
I probably would.
Thank
that's
you.
That Leo.
We worked it out.
That's that Leo shit. That's that Leo.
No,
hey, you show your Leo.
Y'all gonna work it out?
Because after I burned half her stuff down, we'd have worked it out.
Nah, she would have killed you. and you would have set the wrong shit on fire.
Let me ask you something. Suppose she bleached.
What's going on?
Okay, let's say she just bleached it.
That's even worse, man.
Let's say I'm good with bleaching. I can always.
Yeah, you.
Because I still rock some bleach scrubs.
I'm sorry.
If the dry cleaner can't fix it, we like I said, I could clothes I can always get back.
Yeah, that ain't nothing.
Okay. But a mansion, though, bro.
But a whole motherfucking mansion.
It's insured, though.
A mansion.
It's insured. Well, I can get that. It'll get rebuilt, probably bigger and better.
Thank you. Newer too.
Oh, listen.
But that should be a threat. I burn this motherfucker. Next time I'm gonna burn your motherfucking ass up.
I'm gonna burn your ass up in the house, motherfucker.
Steve wanna know what's the number to call.
It's gonna come with consequences because she ain't gonna be able to burn it again.
What's that number up there? Tell him that number.
Well,
we need a pen.
240. I'll tell him to call two.
The number is 240. 5815.
That's our number if you want to call in and tell us if you would stay with somebody crazy enough to burn your Jordans and your motherfucking house down.
Yeah, I'm out.
I'm out, Will. I'm
but
sorry.
But let's not forget, love will make you do some crazy things.
Love will make
things.
You do some fucking
yeah, I mean, I know.
Crazy thing.
Crazy.
And listen, I'm going to be real honest because, I mean, Left Eye is dead. God bless her soul. But she looked like she had that fire. So when you got that fire, goddamn, you will do some
answer room.
Yeah.
Bathroom.
I probably would stay with her.
ATM demon.
That's ATM demon. That's Pooh Bear, man.
Fuck that. I'm out.
Pooh Bear out. Hey, Will, man. Thanks for the call.
Appreciate it, Will.
We appreciate you, brother.
Alright, no problem.
Thank you, brother.
Alright, Will.
Alright.
Thank you, Erica.
Hey, yeah. Hey, man. Appreciate you know, a lot of people
Steve
come.
Steve, say it again. I'm sorry.
Hold on, man. Toucan Dan, man. It's live on the phone.
Can we
phone.
Pin the number?
Hey, what's up, Dan?
What's up, baby?
This nigga called Paul.
Hey, no corona, man. Hold on, y'all.
Shit, Dan is smoking.
Nah, that's not Toucan smoke. That's that weed smoke.
It's your man, Toucan, reporting live from the trees, baby.
Hey, what's up, Dan?
Corona.
Hold up. Miss Bird, I put her ass on.
Let's come on over here, baby.
Go ahead, Darren. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, from my perch, from my view in these trees, I'm considering this. If you burn my shit down, I consider that as, like I said, a terroristic threat.
Yes.
I don't trust you anymore if you are liable to set my shit on
all
fire.
All right, I'm out.
Now, if you got some serious stuff that is of appreciation, and you know what? I'm a man who called before. He said, I'll burn her stuff. No, you got to show me dedication. Set your own shit on fire.
Yes.
After you burn my shit, if we're going to stay together, I want you to get your finest shit together and set that shit on fire.
Why would I set my own fire shit if I'm mad with you?
Because
that guy is, no, I'm saying because that's how I know whether or not you apologize. Now, if you truly sorry, I ain't got to burn your shit because it's going to hurt you more. Then I know we can stick together because I say, you know what? She realized what she did was wrong and she was willing to burn her own shit after she torched my shit. If you say I'm going to burn your shit and we're going to let it go,
Damn, real quick, I think the only way that I can live with some shit like that, if you burnt my shit, I got to burn you. So if you gonna let me brand my name in your ass with a hot brand plate, we might be able to work on it.
Nah, man, I'm out, man.
God damn, Steph, you done turned into Crenshaw Pete.
Yeah.
You can't be putting hot coat hangers on people, man. This ain't the 70s.
Then you gonna be like, I don't like that shit. I'm out.
Listen, yeah, I can't stand looking at that burn mark on your ass.
Yeah,
I'm out.
You would do all that.
Yeah, you know, no, we ain't branding people. Now, like I said, that's just me. That's coming from Toucan while I'm up in my tree. I'm sitting in there watching, and I said, you know what? That's the kind of person I am. If you are willing to set your own shit on fire just to reconcile, then we going to still work it out. But if you're going to burn my shit up and be like, well, that's just what you get. No.
Right.
Not over no Jordan.
Yeah.
No.
Makes sense.
Hey,
happy birthday, Dawn.
Appreciate
happy
it.
Birthday, Miss Nash, Mr. Nash. I put that in there earlier.
Thank you so much.
Yes, man. We appreciate you calling in, Toucan Dan. And we'll see you live here on Thursday, brother.
You know it, baby.
All right, bro. I see
you
calling
through tonight.
Stop coughing,
man.
I'm flying about here, baby.
All right, man. Catch you Thursday, man.
Hold on,
baby. I'm going back in my tree, baby.
All right, hey, give us a call in about 2 minutes, Scuba. We just cleared one of the phone lines. Scuba Jones said he tried to call in.
Steve, the number is 240-339-5815. Steve been trying to call y'all.
Okay, listen. Mr. Aaliyah made a good comment because, see, I was going to ask this question. So, to aims against your insurance, to claims against your insurance. So, are you sure insurance, like, carries liability to a motherfucker getting mad and just burning your house down? In his case, I guess it did, yeah. Because
that's actually a good question
because
hold on, we got another call, man. 4-4 this
Jake from State Farm gonna be like, well, you know.
Hello?
Who this is?
That's probably Steve.
Scuba Jones.
Hey, what's going on, man?
What's good? Hey.
What it do, bro?
Hey, the chick burned my J's, man. Her whole wardrobe gone.
You gonna burn her shit down, Scuba?
You gotta get her back.
I need a female.
I'll leave a couple things.
A female? Because all y'all dudes just on some.
No, Will said
he good. Will said he back. He just gonna burn your shit.
Right, but y'all on some get back stuff.
We'll just go burn some of your shit too. We'll go take some shit and burn it up too.
Scuba, so look, real quick, hey. If you burn her shit, Scuba, nah. Are y'all even? Can you go back to her?
Nah, she burned my J's. Then have her wardrobe gone.
Fuck the J's.
Then I'm gonna keep burning stuff.
Nah, fuck the J's. She burned your fucking mansion. Like Left eye ain't playing.
I mean, where the hell you gonna put your J's at when she burned the motherfucking mansion?
Hey, but the J's are almost like my car. You know what I'm saying? She burned my J's. She's gonna set fire to my car. I ain't playing it.
Exactly.
So you can never forgive her after that shit. You just kind of like,
I seen Stella got her groove back. I seen that.
Okay.
Ain't burning on my stuff.
Waiting to exhale.
Oh yeah, wait till. Oh yeah,
she
yeah.
She burned
yeah.
every fucking.
Matter of fact, that was way too exhale. He said Stella. Stella was getting beat down.
Cheeks was just.
Yeah, because if she start burning your stuff, she gonna keep burning it. That's so. It.
Hey, I never seen.
You know what I'm saying?
You gotta
get. I never watched it.
Hey, Scuba.
Hey, I appreciate. Hey,
thanks for calling. We love the support. Love y'all. Love you, brother.
Appreciate it, man.
Dottie.
Appreciate it, man.
I ain't never met you. I love you too.
All right, man.
Y'all keep it up.
Number love, man.
Number love, bro.
Yo,
okay, we got a female caller about to call her.
Hold on, hello?
Come through, Erica.
Hold on, somebody.
We got the phone lines jumping tonight.
ATL calling too. Erica, come on through, Erica. I'm waiting.
We got a missed call from an 864 number. And then I'm sure somebody else will. We got our phone numbers.
Yeah, we call you back.
We call y'all
Hey, PYO, we call you back.
Yo, what's up, fam?
Hey, what's up, cuz?
What it do?
Man, fuck that. A bitch burn my J's on my Tims. I'm burning her hair.
Burn her motherfucking weed, nigga.
Hey, this shit is flammable. Don't burn my hair.
Dog, if you burn it on
her scalp,
you gonna burn her up.
Don't burn my hair, man.
Damn, cuz. Hey, he might be telling the truth. I mean, to be honest with you, I know this dude. He might be telling the truth.
Hey, that's
like, cuz don't be playing. Like, I ain't even gonna give him, like, he faking. He telling the truth. Yeah. He probably
burned your shit. Pooh Bear gonna burn your weed.
Hey, y'all know I'm stupid.
Yeah, I already know. Yeah, I already know. You.
Yeah.
I take a can of hairspray and a goddamn lighter and torch
it. Just whoosh. We'd be all fucked up. We'd just be flammable, goddamn. That shit burn fast too, goddamn it.
Don't you mess with my weaves and my got to be and my hairspray.
And then, hey, dog, and them motherfucking them little the wigs. You burn them motherfuckers, they get mad.
Sure. I mean, that's how you can get them back, though.
That's the whole outfit, the wig.
Matter of fact, a wig and a couple of outfits. Oh, shit, all the motherfuckers. Just burn. Hey, let her start
some
the fuck
shoes.
Over. Yeah, let her start the
burn
fuck over.
Burn motherfucking heels.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie, y'all. I'm gonna be honest with y'all. Me and Donnie got into it before, and he took my whole makeup box. And I chased his ass.
Yeah, I bet you did.
Makeup and my wigs do not mess with my makeup. Yeah, they're not having
that. You fucking had to go to war with
him. Like, he know what to go to.
I love y'all, yo.
Hey,
love you too, man.
We love you, brother.
Be safe.
Talk to you soon, my nigga.
All right, man.
You're on protocol.
Shit, we had.
Right, we jumping. Yeah, man. Listen, I'm sorry. You burned my house down, goddamn it!
I need a female to call me, because right now we just got the male saying.
I just got a missed call from Erica. Call
right, back. We call you back, yo.
We call niggas back. We not like PGC.
Call you back and you be like,
hello.
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 Come through, Erica.
Hello.
How you doing,
girl?
I told y'all I was gonna call.
You called,
yes,
girl. We
come
got
through,
you,
Erica.
What's good?
So I'm going to tell y'all right now, my stuff and his stuff is going to get burnt together, because we all going to be burnt.
But I said if you started burning his shit first.
Oh, no. Everything's getting burnt.
Damn.
Damn, you're just going to burn everything down, huh, Erica?
Thank you, Phoenix.
Yeah.
But so do you think after you burn y'all shit, that y'all can work things out.
I'm saying, how you burn it? I'm saying, I'm trying to figure out how you burn your shit. Like, you might, shit, I'm out.
So basically, she's saying she's going to burn the whole motherfucker down.
Yeah, I'm just wondering. She just, yeah, you just.
So, Erica, question. Would you still stay yeah. with him? Let's say the roles was reversed.
Yeah, the roles reversed. Yeah.
Oh no.
Right. No. You out? So for yeah. Hey, Eric, I'm with you.
You say no.
Leave.
You say no, Eric.
The next time is you.
Next caller.
Thank you, Eric. You are absolutely correct. You cannot stay with somebody after they burn the shit down. You can't do it.
I need some support. Look at our face.
Thank you. We love you, Erica. One of our biggest supporters.
Talk about those symptoms to make it.
What the hell
was
that?
That's on the phone, man.
We lost you there,
Next
Erica.
Caller.
Riri's mad because she thought somebody was going to check her side.
Hey.
Ain't nobody checking your side.
Caller.
Thank you, Erica. You are absolutely correct, baby.
Miss Phoenix, come through, please.
What she say?
Don't mess with our hair products. Yes, ma'am. Oh, nah, do not
shit.
Mess with
I'm going for your best shit.
Don't mess best with the shit. Hair products.
It's like a girl. It's like a girl going for your game or something. Listen,
Toucan Dan, everybody out there that has a husband, a boyfriend that is a gamer, like me, I love my games. Bro, don't fuck with my PlayStation 4.
Okay, so somebody mess with your PlayStation or your Wii, that's a wrap too?
PlayStation, fuck the Wii. PlayStation?
So
if you break my motherfucking PlayStation, I'm out. Unless you gonna have a brand new one the next day.
That's material shit. We talking about a motherfucking mansion.
Like, oh, the mansion is a wrap. It's a wrap.
Material shit.
I'm not ever talking to you.
But a motherfucker that can set your house on fire.
On an accident. She did it.
I don't believe it's an accident. I think her intention was to burn that motherfucker down.
Yeah.
Nah, cause she was living there too. It's her house.
Don't matter.
It's not like she wasn't living.
Hey, they probably didn't even live in the motherfucker. To be honest with you,
it was already documented that Lisa Left Eye Lopez was already a little off the chain. So he pissed her off. He done been out cheating on her a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, they done had a little physical altercation. She said, "Oh, this nigga went out and bought all these Jordans. Ain't buying me nothing.
Yeah.
I'm gonna burn this motherfucker down."
Right. I think her attention.
And then when she realized she couldn't control the fire, yeah. She said, "Oh shit! I didn't mean to do that."
But if I'm trying to burn down the house, it don't matter. Whew. If I can't control the fire. Maybe. It was an accident. Accidents happen.
Rest in peace, Left Eye. We love you.
Yes, right. Rest in peace.
You know, yeah, I don't care how good that thing is, and it'd be good, goddamn it. But you can't burn my shit down.
Yeah, that shit is.
What if a nigga dogs was inside or some shit? You know what I'm saying?
Oh man.
Burnt my little puppy.
Hold on, we got another call.
Puppies burnt up and shit.
Hello.
Hi, guys.
What's good? Hi.
I'm Miss Nash. Happy birthday, Dawn. What's up, Steph?
What's up?
How y'all doing today?
Hey, we good.
So what's going on? Burning down the house, burning down the PlayStation.
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, we could get y'all real good. All we have to do something to the house,
yeah.
Your dog.
Dog, yeah.
Your tennis shoes. And your PlayStation.
Oh, PlayStation.
And your drinks.
Oh.
Other than y'all will have a fit.
A fit. My guns. Oh.
Your guns?
Yes, I'm going to be so hurt.
You
got a lot of materialistic shoes.
I do. I got a lot of materialistic shit.
Yeah.
My house, though, you burned down.
So, but I mean, that stuff could be replaced.
Okay, Pink. Is it a wrap, though? Like, if that was to happen, like, are you just through at that point? He accidentally burned it.
Say, Dan, burn your shit down.
The house. He burned down the house on an accident.
If he accidentally burned down the house?
Yes.
No, I would. I mean, if he accidentally, it's an accident. Right?
It's an accident.
Huh?
It's an accident. He accidentally burned down. He just wanted to burn down your shoes. That's it.
If he accidentally burned down my house, it's an accident. I mean, but if it's intentional, I would be really upset.
Listen, Miss Pink.
I mean, you can always replace a house.
So you, are you going to stay with them or are you out?
If it was an accident, I'd stay with them. But if it was intentional, I think I'd leave because you had malice in your heart.
Then you're going to hear that.
That's what I was going to get at, because when you want to accidentally burn somebody's shit down, you burn that shit outside.
Yeah.
You don't burn it in the fucking house where you can't control it.
I think she backed out. I think she did it and it just...
But in all fairness, she said she didn't know because the way the tub was made.
Exactly.
It wasn't like a real marble tub. It was made of some kind of material. And before she realized, it was just up in smoke so quick. So that's kind of like an accident. She didn't really know. She was just upset.
Steve said, how do you accidentally burn a house down? We just told you. She put the shoes in the tub. Miss Pink just explained that the material of the tub was not fireproof or whatever it's supposed to be. And then, boom, the whole house set on fire.
Savage Taz couldn't make it tonight, y'all. He's here in spirit. Savage Taz said, you set a leaf on fire, you know the whole damn tree gonna burn. She meant to burn the house down. If she didn't, she would have took the shoes outside. My exact fucking thoughts. When a woman wants to burn something down and get you where it hurts, they know what they're doing. They take it outside and put it in the
laundry. That's not true.
Come on, man.
So listen, when you bleach somebody's clothes, you bleach them in the house. You don't take them outside to bleach them.
Yeah, but fire is
fire is not bleach.
She put them in a tub on purpose. If she wanted to set the house on fire, let's be 100. She would have set the shoes on fire in the room. She could have put it on the bed. She could have lit the bed. Why would I take shoes?
Who was to say that she really put the motherfucking shoes in the tub?
Well, evidence showed that they was in the tub.
So yeah, but she probably put it in the tub before she can get out the house.
She wanted to set the house. Come on now. She's pretty quick.
She's trying to get out the house. She's giving herself time to get
if
out the house.
She wanted to burn the house down, guys. Let's think about it. Why put tiny shoes in the tub? I could just light the sheet to the match. I mean, to the bed, and boom, the whole bed is on fire.
I'm looking at it like this.
I don't think she wanted to set the house on fire.
I think she stood there and watched that shit burn and said, "Burn, baby, burn."
The brother seen that shit. The brother seen that. The brother seen it.
All I'm saying, if she wanted to set the house on fire, why put shoes in a tub? I could just set the damn house on fire. She could have set the house on fire from the outside.
What's up, cuz?
Let's think about it.
Yo, what it do?
Savage Taz in the building. What up, Taz?
Man, ain't nothing. Everybody keeps saying it's an accidentally fire. So to put it like this, if we accidentally sleep with one of y'all family members because they was laying in our bed when we got home, then that's an accident, right?
But that's what Lador did because he couldn't keep his thing in his pants, and it wasn't an accident. So if you accidentally sleep with somebody's family member, that means you went through the motions. It's too many motions to go through to sleep with somebody, so that's not an accident.
It's not. You come home from the club drunk. And she in your bed not knowing you think it's your wife in your bed.
Come on now, really? So now you intoxicated? Hey, why is she in your bed, though? She shouldn't be in your bed.
Hey, why you setting shoes on fire in the house?
Why is she in your bed? Why is she in your bed, though?
Hey, Dan said, I'm with you.
Thank you, Dan. Thank you, Chris. Dan, all I'm saying is she wanted to set the house on fire. She could have set the house on fire from the outside. I don't need to put shoes in the tub to set the house on fire. So if that was her thinking, let's go along with me. If that was her thinking, think about it. I'm gonna put all these shoes in the tub and light it on fire. She could have gasoline the house and lit a match. She should have just threw gasoline and lit a match.
You don't play with fire in the house.
Hell no.
Right, that's what I'm saying. It was accidental.
That shit was to give her time to get out the house. That shit was a good place.
You don't need to set a house on fire from the inside. I can set your house on fire from the outside. And then you wouldn't even know it was me.
I'm not gonna say I'm speaking on experience, but like Don and Taz both said.
If you want to set a house on fire and you want some time to get out the house,
put it in the tub
because you know it's going to stay right there in that area for a brief moment.
And they give you time to possibly act dumb, like you didn't do that shit.
Let me tell you something. You can set a house on fire from the outside. That's all the time in the freaking world. You're not even in there. All I gotta do is get some gasoline and light a match. So why would I go inside a house and light a match?
The same reason she should have just lit the shoes outside.
Let me ask you this. The stuff that you clean your house with, majority of the time, is in your bathroom. All that stuff is flammable. Why set a fire in the bathroom?
The shoes. The shoes.
And Miss Aaliyah.
She could have lit it in the kitchen. She could have lit it in the bedroom. The bedroom would have been the ideal place to light it. Let's be honest. There's clothes in there. There's sheets in there. It probably was a carpet in there. There's no carpet in the bathroom.
She also had been drinking.
The tub was the ideal place.
Listen. She could have lit the house on fire from the outside. That's stupid. So I'm coming in here.
It's stupid
and I
to light.
It's stupid. Light your house on fire stupid. So I'm going to come on the inside. That's dumb.
It's stupid to light shoes in the tub in the house. No. That's stupid.
If I wanted to burn a house down, I'm going to do it from the outside. And then I'm gonna get the fuck. Like I'm gonna run.
Miss
Aaliyah, y'all not gonna
Miss
know
Aaliyah
it's me.
Said, but she stayed. So yeah, she stayed because she knew what
she
did.
She was innocent.
She was fucked up.
No, she
malicious.
Was
malicious.
What? She stayed.
Wasn't he abusive to her though?
Say that again. Huh?
Allegedly.
Wasn't they
in an abusive relationship? They both were abusive
to
each other. Yes.
Allegedly, man.
Allegedly.
Yeah, that's,
yeah.
I mean,
because you said she was fucking him up too. So allegedly.
Go ahead, Chris.
Hey man, listen here.
That's probably why he stayed.
Listen, we both know from hearing from her friends and his friends, they both were crazy as shit. Yeah. Right? Andre was a wild boy. Lisa
Dan
left out as a wild
thank
boy.
You,
hey, appreciate the call, Chris, man. We're gonna get off this topic and keep moving.
Hey Dan, fuck your opinion, man.
Right, fuck your opinion.
Fuck your opinion,
man.
No, fuck your opinion,
Chris. Dan trying to get some love and some
points. Next caller. Fuck your opinion, Chris. You're not even here.
Miss Aaliyah with you.
Miss
Aaliyah said she didn't run because it was an accident.
Miss
Aaliyah, I think that's bullshit.
No. First of all,
all right,
Chris. Chris, I appreciate that.
So yeah, we just
so she
say,
didn't run because she know that she was innocent.
Okay.
Guilty people run.
Okay.
Guilty people
some
run.
Some guilty people.
If I stay at the crime scene, I'm innocent.
Shit, how many people?
I'm innocent.
How many people have you seen on the crazy shows that they be like, we were looking for the victim, the suspect, and then the whole time they were sitting in the muffin crowd looking.
Let me ask you one question. Riddle me this. If somebody wanted to set this place on fire right now, you mean to tell me they have to come up on the inside set on fire, or can they set it from the outside?
They're gonna have to come in because it's brick.
It's
so they can't just throw a bottle through this joint.
They can. That they
can.
That they can.
Like,
yeah,
like,
but to actually take care of it, it's inside.
Let me ask y'all one question, and then we're gonna move on. What is the better way to set something on fire? On the inside or the
inside,
outside?
Inside is the best.
So y'all want to burn up too?
Yep.
Inside is the best way to
you know why? You know why inside? Because from the inside, you know what you're burning. You know what's going to be flammable.
Yeah.
Outside, you got to get through that.
You got to get through the structure.
You know.
Inside, you're going to get something.
I'm not saying I know a bunch of arsonists or a bunch of criminals, but I have grown up with quite a few people.
Most arsonists set fires from the outside. They don't come.
You know
from
why?
The
because they can't get inside.
Thank you. So she was not trying to burn the house down.
She
okay.
was.
She was trying to burn it.
That was her house too.
She was. I think she all right. was trying
rest
to burn
in peace, left eye. We love you.
Yeah.
Andre Rise.
Don't go chasing waterfalls, and if you do, put the fire out with it.
That was good.
Rest in peace.
That was good.
All right, man. On the last note, 31 years ago.
31.
LL Cool J released the album Walking with the Panther.
Give me one song on it.
This album peaking at number one on the Billboard charts.
Bring it hitting the big old butt.
Oh yeah.
I know what. No.
This had Jingling Baby on it. Jingling Baby. Going back to Cali. Going back to Cali.
Cali.
Cali. Going back to Cali.
No,
I don't think
so. Come on, you don't know that?
I heard that before. I think I heard that before. That's not my. That's not my era.
That was that work.
That's not
my era. Yeah, but this album actually it went platinum. It ultimately went platinum. But this is the album that came out before Mama Said. This is his third album. But this came out a year before Mama Said Knock You Out. He took a lot of flack for this album because you know at that time that's when like PE and all them started coming out, and it took some heat because of that, and that's why he came back out with the Mama Said Knock You Out. That was just like a more hardcore album than this junk.
Niggas can say what they want to. We talked about this. LL Cool J, how many CDs does he have? About 17?
Yeah, he got like a good. Yeah, he got a good.
Dude, he's an MC. 13
or 14. Yeah, he has a lot of .
So if you see LL Cool J on TV and he's acting, he's licking his lips, and you like, who is this nigga? Slim was a artist.
Hold on. This dude definitely. This got big old butt on it. I'm that type of guy.
That shit was vicious, nigga. Yeah. That shit.
This
was
album was hot. I mean, when you think about like some of this, and this is basically the same format.
And yeah. I got that shit in my discography when I, you know, on my playlist. Uh-huh. So the other day, me, Summer, and little CJ was riding around in the Crown Vic, we chilling. And on the joint, big old butt came on. Lisa got a big old butt. I know I told you I'd be true. Lisa got a big old butt. So I'm leaving.
So I'm leaving you. Yeah.
Love it. I love it. I love it. Goat. You're right, Dan. Goat was a. I like Goat too. A lot of people said that joint was too commercial.
It was too. Yeah, because at the time the game was changing. On, the game was changing. And then, you know, like he came out with Mama Said Knock You Out. And he just recreated himself again. I mean, that's what LL kept doing. That separates LL from a lot of.
You know what
LL
Cool J stands for, her?
Ladies love Cool J.
There you go. See, you know about the era then.
Yeah, so that definitely.
That nigga, the Briscoe Motel. I'm talking. I go back, man. LL was one of my first joints because he was real hardcore back in the day, man. Before he got all, you know, when he dropped "I Need Love," that was just like, you know.
When I'm alone
and
I'm like, you know, yeah. Dude constantly recreated himself. That's how he was able to last that long. Dude was out in 85, man.
85.
Yeah, and he made it. Shit, he made it to. I mean, he's still out. Actually, he still can drop music.
Head Sprung.
Yeah, he just kept coming.
You know, I mean, what was the other joint he did with the girl? The
Boys the Men joint.
Boys the Men joint. One of the most, his most famous ones was Boys to Men. The
Hey Lover. Hey Lover.
I Need an Around the Way Girl.
Around the Way Girl.
Come on, man. Like, to say LL Cool J is not a dope MC, you don't know music. So, I mean, I've had people say, oh, that nigga whack.
Man, oh, nah. He can actually rap.
That
too,
dude, man. And he can act.
I'll rap you. Yeah, I'll rap your ass.
And he'll fuck you up because, you know, it's the mic on the arm is.
And he'll fuck your bitch.
Yeah. Lick his lips and everything while, you know.
LL Cool J is a married man. He's not fucking nobody.
LL had a serious problem fucking niggas.
LL Cool J is a married
man. LL was fucking so many bitches back in the days. He had a problem. He had to go see a psychiatrist and all type of shit.
He's a married man.
He is now. But
he's happily married. His wife won her battle with cancer.
Well, God bless them.
And she's doing well.
But before before this wife? Shit, LL was terrible.
So, y'all got anything before we jump up out of here, man?
Nah, man, I'm just, you know.
Thanks for everybody that called in tonight. Like, this is probably one of the most...
acknowledgement. So, I just want to acknowledge my brother. He was killed in 1996 on June the 9th. Always acknowledge him on the day he was taken from us and on his birthday.
R.I.P.
I love you, Khalil, and I miss you dearly.
Yes,
June
indeed.
The 9th, 1996. A day I will never forget.
Yes, indeed. And Dan, thank you for telling us it's the same wife, Dan. Only you would come up with no LL, it's the same wife. Well, that's beautiful.
It is the same wife.
And
some shit went down. But that's another discussion, man. We're gonna close y'all out with Jingle Baby. And then actually, we're going to jump off for a second or two, then we're going to get back in, you know. You know how we do. All right.
We appreciate the motherfucking love and the support, man. Go to YouTube, hit subscribe, check us out, keep it moving. This is LL. We got team just jumping
into the team.
Go ahead, baby.
The Jingling Baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The Jingling Baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The Jingling Baby.
Go ahead, baby.
They call me Uncle L. Future of the punk. Records are recorded, minus all the junk. People spread gossip and believe what they must. While I slam dunk dicks
of people. The other one is the remix. He's on the other album.
It is needed to make a phony bony bleed. To put them in a bucket like a chicken feed. Check out the.
All right, y'all. We're going to get y'all the remix.
Nah, we need the remix. You got to have a remix of the Jingle Baby. That was like the hardcore joint.
Yeah, it was because the other one always. I mean, and I used to say, like, "What's the remix?" It's all. And that's
I didn't realize that.
Yeah, that's the original jump right there.
Remix is my shit. Yes, indeed.
All right, y'all. Here we go.
You're jingling, baby.
This is when he came back hard.
And you say New York City. And you say New York City.
Go ahead, baby.
The Jingling Baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The Jingling Baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The Jingling Baby.
Go ahead, baby.
Uncle L, future of the funk. Records are recorded, minus all the junk. People spread gossip and believe what they must. But I slam dunk punks and make them fight the dust. A minute is needed to make a phony rony bleed. To put them in a bucket like a chicken feed. Check out the government and not a quit, I'm nice. Then I'ma dust you up and dust you up twice. I'm just all service, terrible fan. Maddox of the Asiatic Miracle Man. Dominant, dominant, McCoy and I'm real. Another brother's man, look at how you feel. So-so, I got the instinct. They call me Jeopardy Dawn to put your booty in the clink, clink. And dance into a Marley Marl remix single, love. Let me see your earrings jingle, love.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
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 I chopped you. You baked you and sued you. To stop your pop, you need to stop, you kinda rude you. No good nigga boo trying to base. How we living, homes? Get out my face. I'm complete and effective, I can't fall. Ride surprise and I advise you all to stand back and bleep, no sleep or doubt. My skill get ill, I turn the mother out, huh? I'm top notch, you playing hopscotch. Now I'ma do you while the body people watch. You're real funny, you really tried to go for yours. But I know why, you ain't handled no before. So you tried and lied to drain my fame. This ain't a game, yo, you know my name. Innovating, devastating, and don't want a single now. Dance to my remix single.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
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 When you first walked in, I ain't know what to think. Cause you grabbed the microphone like your booty don't stink. And tried to run down that. I can't get over that job that you were saying. You call out a battle rap. How we gon' go against an army with a handgun? I'm LL, you don't understand, son. I'm a legend, on top of that I'm living. Now you look booty like the bum is given. Whoever keeps you up, nah, how should I say it? Whoever set you up, they just had to play it. Cause man, yeah, I feel for you, brother, I'm a bad,
bad.
Taking out suckers while the ladies pucker. Rolling over punks like a redneck trucker. Innovating, devastating, they don't want a single now. Let me see your earrings jingle.
Jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby. Right now.
This is what Pac said he wanted to do. He wanted to break it down like LL in the video.
Go ahead, baby.
The jingling baby.
Yeah, go ahead, baby.
The jingling baby.
Come on, go ahead, baby.
The jingling baby.
Yeah, do it, baby.
Can't believe you tried to keep the same mic as me. Your grip's too weak, you can't hold it, me. Look at dream, I'm making progress and getting this nice. But when I roll up, it's like hip-hop vice. Serve the curves, I never swerve, I'm superb. Every word you heard, play tricks on your nerve. Played your hand, lost track of your plan. When I show up, I blow up and destroy my man. Playing like a poker chip, that's what you get. I bet your breath sweat and regret you met. But tighten the fight, exciting when writing your type. I'm a toy boy, I got it in life, so start writing. You know you can't create and get mean like this. When I'm on the court, you ain't strictly switch. When it's all over, said and done, my friend. It's ALL, Cool J, just scored again. So take a step back, give me some room to rest shop. Here's a choker back, you're getting off at the next stop. I'ma deliver and give a speech with vigor. Pass the wine cooler, you big black.
The jingling baby.
Go ahead, baby.
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 Alright, man, y'all, thanks for tuning in. We'll be back shortly.